who's willing to just play back and also put up a wall that you have to approach from the air from.
Exactly. But Jay still finds some ins, getting some percent when he can. Sadly, it's about 2-1 in terms of percent ratio. Omar is still keeping him out, putting some percent on. That's going to be that first stock with the bell.
And that's the overcommitment problem that you get when you play against Pac-Man. So, right. Colmar knew that he was protected because that Hydro was in the way,
right.
And ended up extending a long time on hit stun, too. They gave him a free punish with that, that bell.
Galaga ship taking the scenic route, not going anywhere important. So it gives Jay a big opportunity here. So far, he's also doing a really good job keeping Colmar in the air, have to say.
Yeah, especially in the second stock here. Like, he wasn't really able to open up before. It's like, all right, let me just approach from a different angle. Let me see if I can start to open up a little bit. But he needs to keep Olimar in the air and then bait out that fire hydrant so he can punish accordingly. But that time, again, he's just consistently getting hit by it.
But that's an interesting interaction that we saw an attempt at earlier, and finally the success. The hit stun with the hydrant and whatnot, definitely not a good recipe.
And now I see why he did it too, because he got a hitbox extension off of that fire hydrant. It's like, okay, he got caught sleeping. Now I get it. But the last hit of side B actually going to keep Jay safe and just evading to the corner. Very smart.
A surprisingly safe move in general just because of the pullback he has in that last hit. So it's really interesting to see. And we talked about the hydrant a lot. I think that's like the one good piece of action Colmar has when it's trying to escape situations like this. So if Jay can avoid those last... Oh my god, if he can avoid the hydrant, he can get quick stocks like that.
Yeah, what was that I said about the ladders being a little bit harder? Not when you follow the DI all the way.
Exactly. And I don't even want to remember because it's irrelevant now. He called you a liar, bro.
I'm gonna pretend I knew that whole time. Okay. He's gone for that. He went for that setup before too, and didn't work out for him. That time though, just catching him overcommitting, trying to approach from the air, gonna take him out. And also, that's something that is very smart to do too. That new up B, being able to just whack out the, like actually poke out the life on it, hitting multiple times. You don't want to let a Pac-Man sit behind that and have to approach from the air.
And down tilt's quick and fast. You can react if the Pac-Man decides to force the issue, but good. Trying to get rid of the charges, and oh, all right. Dude, I'm worried if I'm Colmar now. The jab block, the dash attack.
I'm sorry, what game is this again?
I'm sorry.
that's something we saw a lot in previous history, being able to drag down back air, and apparently still works very well. And looks like Jay is starting to really get a good adjustment on what he needs to do to open up Colmar.
Yeah. That being said, Colmar's in the lead. Until that throw, so... Oh, all right. I was going to say, still can't talk too much.
Yeah, we're at dead even percent here. Like, both of them were... there's a lot of scramble situations, and both of them were just taking tick for tat on in terms of hits. But the big damage comes in when Jay decides to play around near that fire hydrant. But also, up B right now will definitely kill.
Oh, got to watch out, though. Yep. That time, he was ready for it. And I think we talked about that before. We saw a lot of the same setup from Colmar in the drop down. Z dropped the bell, F smash to the left off the Smash Show platform. Yep. And we said, he's got to stop doing that. But same as we said about the dimensional cape on Hydrant. Third time, definitely not the charm for Jay or the Jay fans and audience.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with being committed to the cause, like, sure, of what works. But at the same time, you have to be very weary because Pac-Man doesn't mind staying back. They want you to come at them.
Yep.
So because Colmar got caught on that last one, it's like, okay, this setup is very potentially likely to happen again.
Yeah.
And Colmar loves Z-dropping that bell right in front of him, where if Jay decides to overcommit, he's going to get hit.
That's it, man. You know, a great artist can make a masterpiece, but a true legend can make several. And I think going for that same thing over and over again, definitely the difference between a good and a great player.
Mm-hmm.
Said it plenty of times before. All right, back at it on Smashville. The face monsters.
Yeah,
spears, bro.
Swapping over to the Galactic Knight costume there. I actually really like this costume, but this actually gives him a little bit less room that he has to run around. Actually, no, that's where they went in the first stage. What am I talking about? Never mind.
Same amount of room to run around.
Yeah, same amount of room, same real estate.
But a different counter pick could have been
considered.
The tornado. All right, so I really love this move.
That's the move everybody referred to as busted when this game first came out. And apparently it's pretty busted on dealing with that recovery.
It's so interesting, too, because the move is like fundamentally different than it's been in the last two iterations of Smash. Now there's just like one big horizontal hit. And it looked like Colmar wasn't ready for it that time. Gotta watch out. No grab, though.
Yeah, you see, now Jay playing a mid-range game, just staying back, like running in, running out, getting his hits where he can, because he doesn't want to consistently run in on Colmar, who's been just regularly putting out that Bell Z drop.
Right.
He hasn't really changed his option on that either. And hopefully that doesn't come back to bite him. Doesn't need to worry about it, though, because just going to throw it out.
See, that's the thing. We talked about it before. Meta Knight wants to box with you. Obviously, Pac-Man's going to keep you out. But Colmar sort of planning for the eventuality, like, of what if I don't keep him out? And that's why he has the Bell in the back pocket. He's ready to drop it.
Yeah, all, you know, Pac-Man, one of the characters that's blessed with plenty of get-off-me options. Kind of like that short hop fair and nair, but also that bell. It's like, that's the ultimate stop coming at me. And he's gotten pretty much all of his real estate for stocks off of that.
All right, but Jay on the offensive. Nice little drag down bear to start some action, but going to reset neutral. Back behind the hydrant in the wind box from the clutch.
Opting to go for the down. Oh, actually, that time not even pulling out the vantage there. Luckily, didn't get punished for it, but
right.
I think he was trying to bait out something from Colmar that never came.
All right, well, back to it again. The hydrant coming again. Oh, the slowest of melons, bro.
And he actually respected it heavily, too. Like, wait, hold up. Is he going to try and reach a jump out of me? Like, what am I going to do here? Opt in to just hold shield.
Yep. Oh, nice. I love the nair onto the hydrant. That's the dimensional cape. But yep, Colmar's definitely ready now. Gets the shield up in time. Bell a little wild, but probably thought he was facing the other direction.
And Colmar not feeling, not really feeling that bell there, apparently, that situation.
This one in particular, get him out of here.
This one's defective. And opting to play behind the hydrant yet again. And he put it directly above him. Doesn't matter, though, because he's going to end up sealing it out that upbeat.
Several times now, Colmar has gone for the bell throw and just to throw it out. Mm-hmm. But the fact that he's got to go and pick it up, Jay has been ready under the Smash Bros. Platform with a huge punish in the form of the shuttle loop. Definitely might have to mix it up a little bit, but the key coming in, trying to take the stock and even it up, but good angles.
Yeah, one of the greatest, you know, tools to resource management out of a Pac-Man is not dying there, luckily, for
the littlest back air, too.
The softest of back airs. No sweet spot that could have potentially took that stock.
Yep. Oh, wow. A bold landing near into that F-Smash. Galaga ship coming in, but the dimensional key punish? Not exactly. Bro, he chucked it at him.
It just bounced away.
The confidence.
Is it, he's committed to the cause.
Yeah.
The one thing, all right, finally getting him on the cross-up, reading the roll with that back air.
Yep.
One of the things that has been a bit of a problem for Colmar is that Jay has been using these dimensional capes for free. He hasn't been punished other than when he lets it rip and like actually hits the fire hydrant. Mm-hmm. Colmar needs to seek these out. He needs to find his free damage opportunity to make Jay not want to go for that nearly as much.
Definitely an idea, but, you know, Colmar usually just... He'll just opt to put the shield up. Make sure he's safe in the interactions. Not necessarily go for too much. Oh, wow. Goes deep for the back air. That's actually going to take that game.
I'm actually pretty surprised Colmar decided to jump there, too, because with the all the different options Pac-Man could take, pull out a side B, dig, just go underneath. Obviously, it was a stressful situation. That's the first time Jay dug that deep.
Yeah.
But he's probably going to keep that in the back of his head going into game three.
You know, I know a lot of Pac-Mans enjoy going for the power pull at first because of the armor on certain parts of it. But I think he just wanted to get out of the situation ASAP, and that's what led to that.
And just having that instant trade, too. It's like, okay, now Jay has to go back to stage. If he throws on another hitbox, he's going to SD.
Exactly.
So, all right, going into game three here. I believe they just ran it back to it yet again. Or am I wrong? Nope. I need to pay more attention. So we're going on the battlefield.
Would not make sense to me. We talked about how much sort of real estate there was in that stage. But this is interesting to me. I've seen this a lot, and I've talked about it a lot. I watched a lot of Kiwi, the resident Pac-Man in Connecticut, and...
That's actually what I was just thinking about, too, because I asked, there's like, what is it about Battlefield now makes Pac-Man players want to go here before they hated this stage?
Right.
But apparently it's the fact that without the different defensive options they had before with, like, the air dodges to get by traps, they get to control one-third of the stage almost all the time. And also survivability. They have way better options to recover than most of the characters on the stage.
That's a good point. But if there is one character that's good at recovering, probably Meta Knight.
It's the one with several jumps.
Obviously, Meta Knight definitely not going to live as long as Pac-Man, so I can definitely see the benefits of this counter pick. But in order to reap those benefits, Ajax is going to have to win the neutral. And right now, it looks like Colmar's on the back foot once again.
He just barely missed that forward smash at the ledge, too. That would have definitely sealed that. I like to see Jay's been playing on the hydrant too much. He not only decided to back away, but he reset center. And because of that opening, he let Colmar feel comfortable and finally pulled out the ventral cape. It seems like he's starting to respect Hydra a lot more now.
And there is Colmar once again, just going for the bell. I like the idea, but... The problem is when Jay knows that he wants to set up that bell, it's just like such a big opening.
And when you're up a stock too, it's like, okay, why should I overcommit here? Why should I go at you setting up?
Yeah, it's like, bro, you got it.
Yeah, it's like, no, that's you.
Yeah.
That's you, man. You have that.
Especially, like, honestly, it's been so not impactful. The bells have not really connected into kills, except for like when anything would chill it. Otherwise, Like, he did Bell into up smash at, like, 130 on Meta Knight. It's fine. Like,
exactly.
Bell isn't that big a deal. And see, right there, he dodged it. Still got punished.
A lot of times, playing against Pac-Man, you really end up beating yourself.
Yeah.
Like, that's a majority of their toolkit. And they can play aggressive if they feel like it, but Kolmar is dedicated to the cause of staying back. Like, he knows Jay wants to come at him. He has no other choices, Meta Knight. But with the stock lead right here, you see Jay is... He's willing to play the long game. He's not approaching nearly as much as before.
Honestly, the Pac-Man kind of reminds me of Zage, you know, Zage, yeah. If you will, back in the day. Sometimes you just run through the setups, and I was like, Zage, just like, are you playing, or yep. You just kind of like run through the thing?
And then when Zage found his opening, he'd hit you with like 17 right. Different full footstool setups.
Exactly. So I think the punish game definitely needs some work from Kolmar, but still keeping it close.
And neutral B not going to catch him at the ledge. We were just talking about how that worked so well in his recovery before.
Yeah.
Like the fact that Jay's been keeping that in his back pocket, trying to go high, that's going to punish him for it.
So we're talking about high, he said hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah. All right, Galaga ship, no combo though. Now we see some offense. The problem with Pac-Man's offense is almost completely reliant on forward air, and that's super committal. You have to like run into him to forward air. Nice follow-up from Jay, but maybe not.
Oh, no.
Maybe not the best.
That is, like, he wanted to trade off of that fire hydrant, and the fire hydrant said, not. I'm going to dip real quick. I'm going to come in for my boy and keep him alive.
I was going to say, the fire hydrant, ever trustworthy, said, nah, I got my boy. Like,
and you saw Jay, too. He's like, oh, my goodness. And now Kolmar doesn't get to play that game that he wanted to because he was able to steal that stock out.
The tried and true Smash 4 Classic. Startup hits of the neutral air from Meta Knight. A lot of knockback on them for some reason, so going to take that stock. At a respectable percent. Back at it, though.
Oh, that's the first time he's finally used a dare out of shield. You know, again, we were talking before, all the great out of shield options that Pac-Man has, but can't do anything about this because he has the item in hand, and he had to hold all that. And that's going to be this game going to Jay. That was, he saw, he had the item in hand. He's like, no nairs coming in for you, my guy. No back airs, no nothing. You're holding all of this.
And Devin on the keys, once again, shouts to House for running the wonderful stream. Oh, my God, the shuttle, the loop. Even gave him the world star off the screen. Love
just
it.
Zoom
love
it in, it, just yeah. To remind him how painful that interaction was. And even if he mashed up B, Jay would have been prepared to go and punish it afterwards. That was a very unfortunate spot that for Kolmar to get caught. But you got to take that. When you get that capitalization, you got that moment.
That's the whole point.
Don't
man.
Drop
That's
it. The